Hello student, after the completion of our NCERT in-text solved questions, now we move to the another portion is NCERT in-text unsolved questions. So as we know that in our in-text unsolved questions 10.1, we start with the 10.1. So in the case of 10.1, so they give the such a type of structure. So the question which can be asked, so first of all you open your textbook and move to the your 10.1 number portion. So write the structures of the following compound. And first particularly compound is 2-chloro-3-methyl-pentane. So as we know that in the case of 2-chloro-3-methyl-pentane, so first we have to draw the pentane 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 2-chloro and 3-methyl. So it's 2-chloro-3-methyl-pentane. The number 2 structure is 1-chloro-4-ethyl-cyclohexane. So this is 1-chloro, first we have to draw the cyclohexane, position number 1 and position number 4, so it's 1-chloro-4-ethyl-cyclohexane. Then 4-tertiary butyl-3-iodoheptane. So first we have to draw the structure of heptane, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so it's heptane, 3-iodo, 1, 2, 3, 3-iodo, okay, fine. So now 4-tertiary butyl, so at the position number 4, there is a 1, 2, 3, 4, it's a tertiary because this carbon is attached with 3 carbons, so it's called as a tertiary. So 4-tertiary butyl-3-iodoheptane. So it's a unique one. This, what is the meaning of 4-tertiary? So you have to draw the structure according to them, right? Then after, they give the 1,4-dibromo-butyl-2-ene, 1,4-dibromo-butyl-2-ene. So we give the number 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's 1,4-dibromo-butyl-2-ene. You have to draw the double bond between 2 and 3. Then fifth one is 1-bromo-4-secondary-butyl-2-methyl-benzene. So what is benzene? First one is the benzene. So first the structure of benzene, then 1-bromo-2-methyl. Now they given the 4-secondary-butyl. So at the para position or 4 position, we have to draw the butyl in such a way that this carbon is attached with 2 carbon. So it's a secondary butyl. Okay. So in the case of tertiary butyl is a new one. This is secondary concept. This is secondary butyl. So we have to understand how to draw the structure. After the 10.1, now we move to the another portion is 10.2. So what they particularly give in your 10.2 question, which is on your page number, okay. The question is asked like that, why is sulfuric acid not used during the reactions of alcohol with Ki? What is the purpose that we don't use H2SO4 when we perform the reactions alcohol with potassium iodide? As we know that in the case of H2SO4, the oxidation state of sulfur is +6. So it's the highest oxidation state. That's why it acts as an oxidizing agent. And it oxidizes Hi, hydrogen iodide, means in this case, it's -1. Right, the oxidation state of iodine is -1, which produced during the reactions to iodine, I2. For example, if I perform the reactions Ki with the help of H2SO4, the oxidation state of sulfur is +6 and iodine is -1. So now this sulfur is, now this iodine, Ki, right? So first one is this Ki, when reacts with H2SO4, so first they give the KHSO4 and hydrogen iodide. Now this hydrogen iodide, it's react with H2SO4. Further reaction with H2SO4, at that time your oxidation state of -1 is converted into 0 and sulfur +6 is converted into +4. Because it's an oxidizing agent, so it's convert your hydrogen iodide into what? Iodine. So thus they prevents the reactions between an alcohol and Hi to form an alkyl iodide. To overcome this difficulty, we have to use a non-oxidizing acid such as H3PO4 is used instead of H2SO4. Because in the case of Ca3CH2OH, so it's a replacement of hydroxyl group with iodine and it's converted into KH2PO4 and H2O. So because it's a non-oxidizing agent, while H2SO4 is the oxidizing agent. Then 10.3, write the structures of different dihalogen derivatives of propane. Dihalogen derivatives of the propane. Right? Okay, no problem. If we continue with bromine or chlorine or iodine, it makes no difference. So at presently I choose a bromine. So what is propane? First you have to draw the propane and position number bromine at the terminal position. So 1,3-dibromopropane, 1,2-dibromopropane, at the same position 1,1-dibromopropane and 2,2-dibromopropane. So in the case of this four structure that we have to observe, this 1,3-dibromopropane, 1,2, this is geminal or vicinal? Definitely it's a vicinal hell, right? This is not vicinal, okay, fine, because they are at the opposite directions. While in this case, in the same carbon, it's a geminal dihalide. In the same way, this is also an example of geminal dihalide. So this is all about the 10.3. Now 10.4. Among the isomeric alkane of molecular formula C5H12, among the isomeric alkane of molecular formula C5H12 means pentane, right? So in the case of pentane, identify one that on photochemical chlorination yields what? Because we know that in the case of neopentane, because they give the C5H12, means there are three different isomers: normal pentane, isopentane and neopentane. But in this case neopentane, all hydrogen atoms are equivalent because all are primary in nature. Therefore replacement of any hydrogen of will give the same product. So our answer is neopentane. What about in the number 2, 3 isomeric monochlorides? In the case of normal pentane, if you observe, this is A type of hydrogen, this is B type of hydrogen, this is C type of hydrogen, same way, because both are identical, this is B type of and this is A type of. If we remove hydrogen with the help of halogen like chlorine, right? So we get a product, same way another product, and so we get a three different isomers in the case of this normal pentane. Now the question is four isomeric mono. So in this case, this the identity or this position of the hydrogen, they are identical in nature. This is different one, this is also different one and different one. So we get a first product, second product, third product and fourth. So there are four types of equivalent hydrogen designated as a A, B, C and D. Therefore, four isomeric monochloride are possible. I think so you are clear about the, this is 10.4. Now we move to the 10.5. Draw the structure of, but mind well, they give a major, not minor. We have to focus on major monohalo products in each of the following reactions. So we start with the reactions. This is cyclohexanol. Mind well, this is alcohol. This is not benzene. So it's not a phenol. When it reacts with thionyl chloride, at the time when we have to use a thionyl chloride, definitely there is a replacement of hydroxyl group with the help of chlorine, and we get a chlorocyclohexane. And these SO2 and HCl are gaseous in nature, so they escape very well. So this process is quite good for the to prepare a pure chlorocyclohexane. So this is about the first reactions, and we get only and only product of this chlorocyclohexane, because there is no chance of minor product in these reactions. Now after 10.5 number 1, now we switch over to the number 2 point. So what they given in number 2? Now they give the structure is like that. This is CH2CH3, NO2. This NO2 and CH2CH3 at the para position. So the name of this compound, because they don't mention the name of the compound, but I preferly definitely I mention that this is 4-ethyl, because 1, 2, 3, 4, this is active group. So 4-ethyl nitrobenzene. When it is brominated with the help of heat or UV light, we know that if we show this type of the conditions, delta heat or sunlight, so it's a major chances of free radical. So free radical reactions at this position or this one, because if we move this hydrogen, so it's a secondary free radical and this is primary free radical. We know that secondary free radical is quite stable due to hyperconjugation and inductive effect phenomena. So definitely this, because there are two different products that we have to observe. We have one at here, remaining at here. But what they mention in our question, they mention major monohalo. So major is like that. So now we get the product 1-bromoethyl, this is 1-bromoethyl nitrobenzene. This is nitrobenzene. At the 4 position, you get a 1-bromoethyl. Okay. So it's a very good question, because this position is a secondary one and this is primary in nature. So after the reactions, this is 4-hydroxymethylphenol. So what about the 4-hydroxymethylphenol when it reacts with hydrochloric acid? So when it reacts with hydrochloric acid, because most of the students who are puzzled in this, because these both are alcohol in nature, no, both are phenolic nature, no, this is phenol and this is alcohol, because OH is directly attached with the phenyl ring, is called as a phenol, but OH is not directly connected with the phenyl ring, so it's act as an alcohol. We know that hydrochloric acid is reacts with alcohol, not with phenol, because this reaction is quite tough, because due to resonance structure, we observe that in the canonical structure of this compound, so structure number 2, 3 and 4 having a partially double bond characteristic, so it's hard to break. So the only major product is here, CH2OH, so it's a CH2Cl, so it's a 4-chloromethyl phenol. It's a simple one, but there is a two type of chance, major and minor, but we have to focus on major. Then after, they give the 1-methylcyclohexene. When it reacts with HI, and it's a Marconi co-addition, because they do not mention the Marconi co-addition, but we know that there is a double bond phenomena and we have to add. So here the number of hydrogen is, how many hydrogen? 1, 2, 3, 4. So no hydrogen here. So definitely your iodine is attached at this carbon regarding to Marconi rule. So we get a such a type of product. So 1-iodo-1-methylcyclohexane. Okay, next one is bromoethane. Next one is bromoethane when it reacts with sodium iodide in presence of dry acetone. We know that this reaction is a Finkelstein reaction. And iodide ion, this iodide ion is a stronger nucleophile. So hence it displaces bromide ion. Further, since NaBr is insoluble while Na(I) is soluble in dry acetone, therefore the equilibrium shifts in the forward reaction that we have to already studied in our Finkelstein reaction. Fine. Next one is a cyclohexene, and when it reacts with bromine, but mind well what they give the positions delta and H nu. So at the time, most of the students who are definitely focus on, okay, because this is a one type of addition reactions, and these addition reactions always done on the unsaturation, but no, there is a another concept that we have to use, because in presence of this heat and this light, definitely it's a free radical reaction, but this is double single, so it's a very good position compared to, okay, fine, one option is like that. If you have to bromine, so bromine is a, but it's a minor in nature, but if the bromine is attached at here, so it's a major, because it's an allylic, and we know that double single allylic free radical is quite stable as compared to the our this double bond addition reaction. So we get a 3-bromocyclohexane. So it's a very good concept. So at presence of heat and light, this is called as an allylic bromination. This is allylic bromination. We know that allylic bromination, so allylic group is quite stable. Benzylic group is also stable. So we get a certain type of product. Okay. Now we switch over to the 10.6. They arrange each set of compound. Arrange each set of compounds in order of increasing boiling point. We have to increase the boiling point. For example, they give such a type of option, right? So what they given in this case? CH3Cl, CH3Br, CH2Br2 and CHBr3. For the same alkyl group, this all are having the same alkyl group. Boiling point increase with the size of halogen atoms, so chlorine and bromine. So definitely the size of bromine is quite good. Therefore, the van der Waals attraction in this case, so methyl bromide having a very good van der Waals attraction. So methyl bromide having a higher boiling point. Okay, fine. Now, further the boiling point is increased as the number of halogen atoms is increasing. Therefore, the boiling points of bromo form, this is bromo form with a 3 bromine atoms is the highest. followed by this is dibromomethane with two bromine atoms, while bromomethane with a one bromine atom is the lowest. So combining all these arguments, right, we presented the boiling points of this four compound, which can be increased in order like that. Okay, now number two, in this case the one chloropropane, isopropyl chloride and one chlorobutane. Okay, but for the same halogen, as we know that the boiling point, same halogen, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So in this case, this is a primary nature, this is secondary in nature. As the size of alkyl group is increasing, therefore the boiling point of 1-chlorobutane is higher than those of 1-chloropropane or isopropyl chloride. Further, the boiling point decreases, the branching is increasing. This is branching is increasing because in this case branch is increasing. Therefore, the boiling point of 1-chloropropane is higher than that of isopropyl chloride. And we know that there is a higher number of carbon. So, definitely the boiling point is increasing. So, this is all about the 10.6. After 10.6, now we switch over to the our next portion is 10.7. Which alkyl halide form the following pairs would you expect to react more rapidly by SN2 mechanism? Okay. Index question, just a minute, 10.8, okay. The question is like that, which alkyl halide from the following pairs, so they give the two different type of pair. This is CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2Br and another is CH3, CH2, CHBr, CH3. So we know that SN2 reaction which can be comfortable in primary alkyl halide. So in this case CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2Br is a primary alkyl halide, while this CH3, CH2, CHBr, CH3 is a secondary halide. Since there it will be some steric hindrance in secondary halide than primary alkyl halide, therefore this reaction or for this will react faster than the remaining compound. Number 2, CH3, CH2, CHBr, CH3. We know that it's a secondary alkyl halide and they give the tertiary alkyl halide. But we know that in the case of tertiary alkyl halide, there is a steric hindrance. While in this case, this is a lesser steric hindrance. So this secondary alkyl halide reacts faster than tertiary alkyl halides. Right? So number three is a CH3, CH, CH3, CH2, CH2Br or CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, CH2Br. But in this case, your methyl group is far from this bromine, while the another example is CH3 which can be positioned here, so it's nearer. So if the methyl group is near to the CX bond, it means there is a steric hindrance. So here both 1 and 2 both are primary secondary halide, but in alkyl halide where the methyl group is C2 is closer to the bromine atom, while in this case a bromine is far a little away from the bromine atom, as a result alkyl halide will suffer great steric hindrance, right? So therefore this structure or will react faster. Next 10.8 that we have to already discuss in our prior portion 2. So in the following pairs of halogen compounds, which compounds undergoes faster SN1 reaction? Faster SN1 reaction. Just a minute. In text question. Okay. So in the following pairs of halogen compounds, which compound undergo faster SN1 reaction? Right? So once again, this is this compound. Because it's a tertiary alkyl halide, it's a tertiary alkyl halide, but this one is a primary alkyl halide. This gives a tertiary carbocation which is more stable, while this one gives a secondary carbocation. So definitely our answer which can be 1, right? Next one, both halide, this is secondary in nature and this is primary in nature, and we have to focus on this SN1 mechanism. They produce a secondary carbocation while this one produce a primary carbocation, but we know that secondary carbocation is more stable than primary carbocation. So this compound is quite faster in the case of this compound is faster in SN1 reactions compared to this compound. Now identify A, B, C, D, E, R and R dash in the following reactions. Okay. So what we have to observe in this case. Fine. So first they give the cyclohexyl bromide. this, they give the cyclohexyl bromide. When it reacts with magnesium, so magnesium is definitely attached with this carbon and bromine, so we get a cyclohexyl bromide, cyclohexyl magnesium bromide. This compound is A in nature. Now, hydrolysis of this cyclohexyl magnesium bromide, so at that time H plus and OH minus, so they reacts with the M, because MgBr is a minus in nature, so definitely they reacts with the OH minus. Okay, so MgOHBr, and this H plus is attached with this ring, so we get a cyclohexane as a product B, right? Number B. Okay, then RBr, this RBr plus magnesium in dry ether, we get the compound C, and with the help of D2O, they give the, such a type of compound, right? So what is C? What about the C? So in this case, our compound, which can be RBr with the help of magnesium, right? So since here the D compound gets attached to the same carbon atom on which MgX was present, therefore, so RBr is equal to CH3CHBrCa3, or R is equal to Ca3CHCH3, right? That's, and C is equal to CH3CHCa3MgBr. So the third part of the question is wrong, because third part of the question is why wrong? Because tertiary alkyl halide do not undergo Wood's reactions, but undergoes dehydrohalogenations to give alkyne. So R1 is equal to CH3 thrice C, and hence D and E R is a different in nature. D and E R, they are different in nature, because if we perform the reactions, this R dash X, so this R dash X, when we have to react, so okay, CH3CCH3Br, when it reacts with sodium in presence of ether, right? So because it's a tertiary in nature, so we get a, such a type of product, is a 2-methylpropene. But if we connect with magnesium, right, so we get a D type of compound, tertiary butyl, and the hydrolysis which is give convert into 2-methylpropane. So this option is, because we know that Wood's reaction is not performed with the help of tertiary halide, because at that time your tertiary halide is undergo a dehydrohalogenation because there is a presence of strong base. Okay, so this is all about your index solved question, unsolved question, sorry. Now we, in next session, we starts with our NCERT exercise step by step. Thank you very much.